Yo, what's good YouTube? This is Jay from TNJ. And we are now back with this Marquette series. We did take a little bit of a break. I mean, it's just that MLB is just going so strong, but we're back for this series. And a couple of things to catch up on. Catching up on the recruiting here. Christian Driver, still the number one receiver in the land. He's looking to come to Marquette. And Jimbo Brown, Miles Power, Zach Wood, all of our top guys here, with the exception of Zach Wood. Zach Wood and all these guys after Miles Power are just, we're losing them a little bit. And here's the thing, is that when we're this good of a school now, all the top prospects want to come. But that means that now that we're getting top prospects, they're considering the big schools as well. We're no longer swimming in the small pool. We're in the big pool now, trying to get these big fish. So now look at Nick Catalan, one of the best free safeties in the country. Like I said, we're losing some of these great guys to these better schools, but except him. I don't know what Jace Betts is going for there. We only have 280 on him, but here's the thing. He's trying to go to Miami, Ohio. I don't know why he would want to go over there over Marquette. Probably because it's his home state. I understand that. But some of these guys, I don't really understand why they wouldn't want to come. Why wouldn't you want to come to the national champs? So looking at the rest of these guys here, we're in all right shape. I mean, half these guys do still want to come to our school. Half of them don't. Jordan Gronowski here, he's a 69 overall receiver. He wants to come. Looking at Kashawn Curtin, he doesn't even want to come. Or he does want to come. So, and we have 125 on him, so it's kind of surprising to see. Maybe it's because they're lower overall and kind of overlooked in recruiting. They still want to come to our school, but some of the top guys just, they're not showing much interest. I mean, Christian Driver is definitely going to be the driver, no pun intended, of this class. But besides him, you know, we do have a couple of more guys, but not a huge recruiting class for us, not yet at least. So now looking to see who's ahead of us in the top 25. Alabama still at number one. We have them next week, but this week we are going up against Georgia. They are ranked number 17. We're ranked 12. And looking at who they play, they lost to Miami, but I mean, they got a pretty good offense and defense. I mean, they're ranked pretty much in the middle of the country, but nothing's bad. Nothing's bad. Nothing's great, overwhelming. So let's hop into this gameplay right away. We start this game off by giving the ball to Alex Brown on the handoff up the middle. Then we find Kevin Oliver on a 3rd and 3, and he puts a deadly juke move on the defender that time and gets a 60-yard reception. Take another look. Just making that defender look silly, and he dives into his own guy that time, and we capitalize for the 60-yard gain. So on a couple plays later, Ben Miller gets open in the end zone for the touchdown. And Ben Miller, one of the best tight ends in the land, nothing more you can say about that. And I mean, our offense is rolling right now. I mean, remember last week we couldn't really get our offense going versus Auburn early, but I mean, this week is looking pretty good. So here we're facing a very, very good running back in Chris Reed, and he's getting the ball that time, stiff arming the mess out of our defender. And on a 3rd and 12, they're finding the first down sticks is Clayton, and he's pretty good. I mean, he can move a little bit. As you can see, he's running here. He's an impact player, and here he gets another first down. So now they're inside the red zone. Clayton on a 1st and 10 from the shotgun is going to throw to the right, but John Waters is going to be there for the interception. The first mistake made by Clayton. Hopefully it'll be a lot more in this game. So now we come back out on offense, finding Jamel Cooley over the middle. And Jamel Cooley is definitely a guy that, you know, when we first recruited him, he was one of the top prospects, and he definitely is living up to the bill. I mean, he's everything that we want to be. We are, we maybe should be more selfish with him, but here's the thing. We have a bunch of good guys on our team. We spread the ball out pretty well, but I mean, if we really wanted to, we could probably hog it with Jamel Cooley and he would dominate, but that's just not the way to go. But out of 3rd and 6, you can see 3rd and 5, we do get sacked on that time. lose a yard, so we do have to settle for the long field goal. So it's a 10-0 lead in this game. So now they give the ball off to Reed, and Reed's fast, man. You saw when he got that draw play, he took off. That was 17 yards. It didn't even seem like it was that many yards, but that's how fast he is. So here is Clayton, too. He's running the ball, and he fumbles. Luckily, he recovers his own fumble. So now facing a 3rd-and-7, barely past the 50-yard line. This time, he's finding his favorite target, Mark Webb, on the outside that time. So now Clayton throws to the middle, and that one's going to be a near interception for Vince Cohen. And Vince Cohen has definitely been our guy, but he does drop a lot of interceptions as John Waters almost gets his second interception, and they do end up settling for the field goal. So on the next drive, Jackson Lindahl puts a mean spin move on the defender that time, getting a nice 24-yard gain. So close to the 50-yard line, giving the ball to Alex Brown up the middle for the nice 6-yard gain. So facing a 1st-and-10 this time, Jamel Cooley getting open this time from the slot, and he's getting the first down. So we're rolling on this drive, getting towards halftime, and now Albert Vicks rolling out right this time. He's going to throw the ball deep, and Jamel Cooley, like I said, we can hog the ball with Jamel Cooley if you really want to. He's just an overall beast as it is, and Jimmy Ward finishes off the drive, and we do get in for the touchdown. So now it's a 17-3 lead, 2.5 minutes left in the second quarter, and Reed is just a beast. Look at him breaking all kinds of tackles, breaking another tackle, and luckily Josh Dunbar does catch up to him, gets the tackle, and saves a touchdown run on that one. So now 1.5 minutes left in the first half, 3rd-and-4, and they get the first down. Mark Webb for the 5-yard reception. And now Clayton drops back, throws to the outside one more time, but Vince Cohen drops yet another interception, and they're going to capitalize on the next play, finding Mark Webb, his favorite target, and that is going to be a touchdown for Georgia. And look at this. On the last drive, we didn't really notice it, but Albert Vick got hit on one of the throws, and he has a mild concussion. He's out for the game. So now we bring in our backup quarterback, Patrick Williams, the sophomore. He's got 85 speed, but he hasn't played at all this year. And on his first pass, overthrowing a wide open Ben Miller in the corner. So now facing a 2nd-and-10, he throws a wild one. That looks like it was intended for Kevin Oliver, but it was actually intended for X, the crosser, the slant route going across the middle, and he severely overthrows his receiver, and Georgia's going to take over right before half. So what a bad mistake that was by Patrick Williams on that throw, because we set him right up with great field position. And a couple of plays into the next possession, they find Marlon Alexander in the back of the end zone, Anthony Jeter. Like I said, Anthony Jeter is, you know, I don't want to anoint him as the defensive star, because he is kind of, he's kind of like the definition of boom or bust. You either are going to get a pick with him, or he's going to give up a big play. And that's the thing about Jeter. I mean, he takes a lot of risks. He gives up a lot of big plays. I mean, that's the thing. He's a beast, but you just don't know what you're going to get out of him each play. So now back out on offense is Georgia, and Reed is just beast in this game. Another beastie run. He breaks a couple of tackles and breaks out a 47-yard run, and Georgia takes its first lead of this game. And now we're back on our offense. Can Williams get it together and put together a nice drive? Nope. Dudley is going to be there for the interception, and he's going to actually take this one all the way for the touchdown. So Alexander misses a wide open slant route, then a wide open Ben Miller over the middle, so we have no choice. We bring in the sophomore, the Drew Brees-like quarterback. Amazing accuracy at 90, but 70-something throw power, and he's going to be looking to get some accurate throws, because we need this. I mean, we need some quarterback play. I mean, with Albert Vick out, it's kind of hopeless. So on a 4th down, though, he just overthrows Ben Miller. I mean, he was wide open as well. Maybe it's these jitters. Maybe they're nervous going into SEC play. I don't know. But we turn the ball back over to Georgia, and they have the two-score lead inside the red zone. So on a third and four here, Clayton's going to give it off to Ellison this time, not Reed. And we're going to stop Ellison before he gets to the first down marker. But they are going to settle for the field goal, and it's going to be now a two-touchdown lead for the Georgia Bulldogs. So back on offense, here's Joseph finding Ben Miller over the middle, but Ben Miller cannot hold on to it. And you know what? We got to go for it because our defense is just not stopping their offense. So Caden Joseph from the shotgun is rolling out left, going to throw back across his body, and he's barely going to sneak it to Kevin Oliver, and Kevin Oliver is going to barely get past the first down marker. So now on a first and 10, a minute and a half left in the third quarter, Caden Joseph is going to find Jackson Lindahl on the outside that time. And here he is once again finding RJ Schultz across the middle. So now we're past the 50-yard line, almost in the field goal range, but we can't take field goals at this point because, I mean, we need to score. Our defense can't stop their offense, really, especially Reed running the ball. So now on a first and 10, Caden Joseph's not going to see anybody open. He's going to run the ball, but he's going to cough it up, and Georgia is going to recover. And what a disastrous game it's been for our quarterbacks, our backup quarterbacks. Patrick Williams throws two interceptions within his first five passes, and then Caden Joseph fumbles, and look at this. Reed is just beasting us this game. He breaks a tackle pretty much in the backfield and busts it open for a 63-yard touchdown run, and that is going to be pretty much a dagger. It is a three-score deficit for the Marquette Golden Eagles. I mean, we can come back. There's 6.5 minutes left, but the comeback is just improbable as we haven't given the ball much to Alex Brown up to this point. He's kind of been really quiet, and mostly because this defense, look at him. They're just getting after the ball as they force another turnover on a fourth down. Look at this. Look at that spin move that he put on Raphael Wheeler, and he gets to Caden Joseph. So now Georgia takes back over. 4 minutes left in this fourth quarter, and on a third down, he just delivers a dart to his receiver that time for the first down. So now they're inside the 20-yard line. Here's Clayton, run the ball once again. Look at this, breaking a tackle, but we do get the strip, and we get the ball back, but it just might be a little too late. I don't know why we're celebrating here, but there's 3 minutes left in this game. And here is Ben Miller showing some signs of life, getting the reception and getting a lot of yards after the catch that time. And Caden Joseph at least is throwing the ball with a little bit of accuracy now as RJ Schultz gets the reception across the middle, close to the 30-yard line. So now it's two and a half minutes left. The clock is ticking, and here's Caden Joseph rolling out to the right, and he does find Jackson Lindahl in the end zone for the touchdown. And we do decide to kick it deep. We don't decide to go for the onside kick because we got three timeouts left. So here's the first one. We do get them to get stopped before the first down, and they try to run a screen pass, and that's going to force a punt on the sack that time. They didn't want to throw the screen for an interception. And back out in the punt game, here is Amonra Watkins getting a nice return up to about the 35-yard line. So now facing a second and four, 2 minutes left in this game. And who knows, we're moving the ball pretty nicely as Alex Brown does get into the end zone for the touchdown. And now that I've been calculating this, maybe if we would have went for two a couple of times, we would be down by 8 points. But instead, we're down by two scores, and we try to kick the onside kick. And Marlon Alexander is there to scoop it up, and we go on to lose this game. The SEC competition has been real so far this season as Georgia takes care of business at home, upsets Marquette. I don't know if this is really much of an upset. They're only five spots ahead of them, But Georgia takes care of business, and we got to bounce back from this. It wasn't a pretty game from our backup quarterbacks. Both had at least one turnover, but that the dropped interceptions by Vince Cohen, the two turnovers by Patrick Williams just killed us. Those are just horrible throws, and it ends up biting us in the end as we go down. And you know what? Georgia didn't really do much through the air. It was really just Reed just tearing us up with those long runs. And I mean, our defense just couldn't stop Reed. We couldn't wrap him up. And I mean, we got to bounce back from this. I mean, the SEC competition is not going to get any easier, because next week we are going up against Alabama, and you know they're ranked number one. Chris Reed goes for 208, so hit subscribe, hit that like button, because you don't want to miss our game versus Bama. We do have to bounce back, our first loss in 2 years, so you don't want to miss any action coming up. Stay tuned. Let's go.